And good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mr. Feeney, for all intents and purposes. I'm the athletic director at Bishop Connolly High School, and I'm sitting alongside Nathan Craig Machado, who is going to provide some color analysis of the game, along with Colby Nowicki, who's going to be doing camera work. And we're here to bring you one of the end of season matches, soccer matches between our home team, the Bishop Connolly Cougars, and the Diamond Bengals. Bishop Connolly Cougars coming into this game, I believe, with a 14-1 overall record. I'm not quite sure what their league record, but suffice it to say, it's pretty good, and they're looking to finish with a pretty high seed going into the playoffs. The Diamond Bengals, just checking my notes here, come in with an 8-4-3 record. So obviously, they're going to have some pretty good, they're probably going to have a pretty decent seed going into the state playoffs as well. The Cougars and the Bengals faced off, I believe, this past Thursday, okay, and a match won by our Cougars by a final count of 2-0. For some analysis of the Diamond Bengals, I'm going to bring in Nathan Craig Machado.
Hello, everyone. This is Nathan Craig. Diamond likes to be pretty aggressive with the ball. They like to bring it up really hard and fast. A very aggressive team. They have, offensively, they're pretty coordinated, as well as defense, too. They can switch it up between both. That's pretty much it.
All right, so it looks like we're set up for a pretty good game. I mean, the Cougars have quite simply had a great season. There was a stretch during the year during which they were not only undefeated but unscored upon. They finally did give up a goal, and I believe they gave up two goals or three in their first loss. I forget how many goals they gave up during that loss. But suffice it to say that they've had a tremendous season, and they look to go into the state playoffs on a winning note.
Would you like these, or do you want me to take it later?
I'll get them from you at halftime.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay, so we're just about ready for action here at Connolly Stadium. It's pretty windy and cold. The wind is certainly, I'm not sure what direction that would be, but the wind is blowing across the field from left to right. Not sure how much of an impact that will have on the game itself. So we're only a couple of minutes away from game time. Rather sparse crowd here, but if you're so inclined, come on down. Trainer makes her way into the stadium. Waiting to see who the Cougars and the Bengals send out onto the field for a starting lineup. I know that for the Cougars, Nate Chim is a scratch. Nate, is he a healthy scratch, or what's the deal?
I believe he'll be back by the end of the week. He took a pretty hard hit by one of the Bengal defenders. Left him with a minor concussion, I think, maybe a couple of sores. But otherwise than that, I think he'll be back.
All right. I know that I might be wrong on the number here, but I'm pretty sure that Nate set a record last year, school record, I believe, with 26 goals. So Nate's only he's a LEAP student, but he's technically a 10th grader. So he's obviously a big part of the Cougars' offensive weapons. So hopefully they get him back sooner rather than later. There's also a cross-country match going on at the same time as today's soccer match, but it shouldn't interfere with anything all that much.
We had two. Now we got one person's watching.
What? Yeah, for the starting lineups, I will once again, bring in Nate.
Okay, starting for the Cougars, we have Zach Brohl. So, starting for the Cougars, we're going to have John Aguiar with Ryan Arruda, John Paul Viveris, Nick Sass, Ruben Feria, Nico Ferreira, Sam Hartstead, Kyle Oliveira, Brandon Arujo, Aiden De Silva, and I believe Zach Brohl and Austin Fernandez.
Now, as a somewhat novice soccer guy, I have to admit, as some people know, may or may not know, I'm a baseball guy. I followed sports all my life, but soccer is just, it's a great sport. I realize that there's a tremendous amount of athleticism involved in this sport, but it's not exactly a sport that I've taken to. So, as such, here's my question, Nate. Is it 11 on 11, 9 on 9, what is it?
11 on 11, Code.
All right, so that would explain why when I've been arranging some of the games this year, some of the coaches have said this game will be 7 on 7 or 9 on 9, indicating that there's a difference. Okay, so soccer obviously is getting bigger and bigger in this country, to the point at which I think it's taking players away from other sports, be that as it may, but all things do change.
One of the fastest grossing. It's actually one of the fastest grossing college sports, actually, for the past couple of years. We're getting up there in numbers, so.
Yeah, I've seen that over the course of the last 20 years, actually, having been at another school earlier. And it looks like we're ready for action here at Connolly Stadium. I see Nico Ferrara out there. Why don't you give them the position? Yeah, why don't we get the starting lineup and their positions?
So we have Nico Ferreira as left front. Then we have Austin Fernandez, number 4, being main striker, center strike, followed by Sam Hartstead, who's also going to be a center striker. And we have, I believe that is John Aguiar for right striker. Center mid, we have Ruben and John Paul, Ruben Ferreira and John Paul. And for our defense, left back, we have Nick Sass. Center back, we have, I believe that's Kyle Oliveira and Aiden De Silva. And right back, we have Ryan for Arruda.
Ryan Chico Arruda, as he's known in the halls of Bishop Connolly.
Think you can handle play-by-play?
Yeah, let's try it, because I might end up
sounding like a fool.
You take that. Oh, you might need that. Okay, I think we're going to move right over to Nathan Machado for play-by-play. Just waiting on... not quite sure what we're waiting on.
Oh, the goalies have to get ready.
Okay, it looks like we're ready for action. So for our play-by-play, I will turn this over to Nathan Craig Machado.
Okay, folks, looks like we're almost ready to start. Goalies are ready and the ball takes off. Sam passes it back to Ruben. Ruben's going to take it up the middle. Oh, and he crosses it down to Nico. Inside the box, and I believe the goalie will take that. Goalie's running a little bit of time before punting it out. And here it goes, folks. And Diamonds recovered the ball after a header by Ruben. Now Aiden has given possession down to our goalkeeper, Jacob Castro. He passes up to Aiden. Looks like they're going to go up the sidelines. Okie dokie. Passes it back to the middle where there's Ruben. Pass it off to Nick Sass. And Nico goes for the save, almost out of bounds. As you can see, Diamond's being very aggressive right now on the offense, trying to get the ball back and set it back to their goal, to our goalkeeper, rather. And Diamond inbounds it, and Ryan kicks it back out. Diamond inbounding again. Let's see who that is. I believe that is Curtis Mello throwing in the ball. And Conley recovers the ball. Oh, switch back to Diamond position. Possession. I believe that was Ruben who cleared the ball. Curtis Mello inbounds it again. Kicks it off to Aiden. Oh, and we got number 15 going on a run. 15 would be Colin Bugera. And Conley gets possession of the ball again. Never mind, it's switched back to Diamond. And Diamond is now inbounding the ball. Curtis Mell, once again, I believe they're relying on him heavily for throwing it in. They're inside the 18 right now, and I believe that was Andy Silva that just cleared it.
Okay, while we're waiting here in the slight break in the action, I just let me set the players for you for in case there's any Diamond fans watching the game. Players on the field right now are Neil Souza, Brandon Souza, Alex Almeida,
Curtis Mello.
Dominic Rocha.
Colin Mello.
Corey Arruda, I believe. Doing our best here, folks. We're looking from a distance. Just trying to...
Dylan Mora.
Okay, I'm going to slide this back over to Nate while the action's in play.
Well, I believe we're looking at a goal kick here, folks. Dominic Rocha kicked it out, giving us a nice free lob into the middle, hopefully. And off goes Jacob Castro. Ruben tries to get in front of the ball, but is contested with Dominic Rocha once again. But Ruben recovers with it. Passes it off to Aiden Da Silva. And the ball is run up to the sidelines. Out. Diamond ball.
Now, I do have a question. Something I've been wondering about. When the ball is inbounded, is it a rule that they have to do it with both hands?
Yes, both hands, and neither of their feet can come off the ground. They also have to drag it a little bit. Also, you can't like fake it out like you would do in basketball, try and make a fake pass. It has to be straight and direct. No snake eyes or anything like that either. Okay, and Ruben passes it down to Austin Fernandez. He takes a shot, and the goalkeeper takes it. Not a bad save, if I do say so myself. And there's a goal kick. That would be Sam contesting with Curtis Mello for that ball. And Curtis emerges victorious in that battle. But Sam's not done. Oh. Off down the sideline and into the out zone. Have Ryan Arruda throwing it in. And it goes to Aiden. Aiden then kicks it off to Kyle Oliveira. Then pass off to Nick Sass. Nick Sass is going to take it up. kicks it down to Nico, I believe. Yep. And they're off. Nico with a nice switch. Cross it into Austin again. Who's going to look to be replacing Chim right now as the main scorer, as he is also a very nice finisher. Okay, we have Ruben taking control of the ball now. Oh, and it's into Diamond possession. That's our goalie's ball right there. He's gonna take it up. And off to Sass it goes. Sass is then gonna take it up, pass it off to Nico. And that is, I believe that was Neil Souza who took the ball from him. Nice. Back to Nico. All right, that's out on Diamond, boys. Anderson's going to take up the ball a little bit. Runs it down to John John, and John John is off like a gun. Okay, Diamond's regained possession of the ball. But I believe that's going to change very quickly. Let's see it. All right, Diamond is now inbounding the ball. And once again, kicked out by Bishop Conley. Diamond ball again. Oh, never mind. It's Conley ball. Chico passes it off to Aiden. Aiden sends it down to Kyle. Kyle sends it over to Nick. I believe we're seeing a pattern here, folks. They're trying to run onto the left side of the field. And that is out on Conley.
So when you say a pattern, are you saying that you think Conley is deliberately trying to work the left side of the field?
I believe so, as seeing that most of our players are ambidextrous with their legs. They often can make any type of kick, which is really nice for us. I think Diamond is expecting a very strong lead with the right, but right now it seems to be working for us because we're bringing it on their side of the field more than they are.
She was waiting till the season ended to get it checked out.
Aiden takes control of the ball and sends it back to Castro. And Castro off to Sass. And Nico regains possession of the ball. He seems to be running it up, using his speed. And down to Ruben. Ruben then sends it off to JP. JP kicks it to Sam. Sam heads it, and Diamond has possession of the ball again. Nico's running to contest that ball. Oh, and he takes it. Is he going to go on a run? We'll see. Nico dribbles it over. In the box, folks. He's in the 18. Oh! And no call. There you go. I believe that was Colomelo bringing it out, folks. Let's see. Ruben inbounded it to John Paul. John Paul then kicks it off to Aiden. Aiden launches it back to Kyle. Once again, working the left as I predicted before. Nick sends it to Austin. Austin crosses it to Nico. And Diamond has control again. Jacob Castro sends it down to Aiden Da Silva. Aiden gives it off to John John. John John passes it back.
Keep on forgetting. I'm calling them by like their nicknames.
That's all right.
All right.
And we have Castro taking the ball. Then rolls it down to Sass. Sass crosses it to JP. JP sends it to Nico, and I believe Nico saves the ball from going out. He's going to run it up. And Diamond now has control of the ball again. Oh, Bishop calling the control now, boys. Nick Sass inbounds it to Ruben. I'm just going to take it back a little bit before crossing it down to Ryan Aruda. Nico tries to regain the ball on the failed attempt, but that's okay, because I believe we're about to get it in anyhow. Chico's not inbounding the ball. And he sends it to Ruben, who's now contested by two of Diamonds, and he breaks through, running it down the middle. And Diamond has regained control. I think we're seeing right now Diamond's been focusing a lot more on the defensive, something they learned from Thursday's game, I believe. Making sure we don't have too many runs down there and not leaving a single man open, oftentimes double teaming them, which can, though, lead a fatal flaw in their defenses. Someone can't get open. Bringing it up, pass it off to Austin. Austin, take control of the ball. So 4-on-4. All right. Here we go. Nico has been getting very stressed on the left side of the field, often being worked more than most of Conley right now, seeing as they're sending it down to their left striker a lot. Kyle Oliveira with the lob, sends it off into Diamond, and Nico tries to regain control of the ball. JP with the kick, and Sam with the save. Takes the ball, passes it off to Nico. Nico's breaking through the defenders. Oh, come on. Ruben stopped there clear, and he is now bringing it up the field. Ooh. See what happened there. Seems Nico's been hip checked, folks. I believe he'll stay on the field. He'll be good. It's going to result in a kickoff for us, and we have it. Sam now has control of the ball, passes it back to Ruben. Ruben crosses it into John. John, let's see if we can finish. Oh, it's not over yet, folks. Still in this, and they clear it. Out. Bishop Conley possession. Crosses it to 14, 14 to 12, and it's out. Conley ball. Sass is going to inbound it, pass it off to Ruben. Ruben takes it down the field a little bit, gives it to goalkeeper Jacob Castro. Something you folks should know, Jacob Castro has a very unusual way of playing goalie. He's one of the most offensive goalies I've ever seen at times. He'll even run... He'll make it up to half field, run it to half field as a goalie, which is something we don't see that often over here. But for Jake Castro, I guess it works because, as you've heard before, only 3 goals have been scored on us this season. So.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he still is national. Some national team. Should I put that in there?
So a little bit of information about our lineup. We have a couple of players there, Aiden Da Silva and Jacob Castro, both playing for national teams, along with John John and Ruben, I believe, as well. We also have several other teammates that play for out-of-school clubs, which, like Sam and Ruben, who just cleared the ball out to Sam. Another one of those plays is also Nathan Chim, who's not playing right now. As previously said, he's been injured, so he's out for this game, but he'll be back in by the end of the week, I believe. Okay, Chico now has control of the ball. It's out on Diamond. Bishop Conley now has control. Ruben's taking it up, crosses it to Sass. Sass tries to trap the ball. Doesn't work. It's okay, though, because we have Kyle Oliver on backup. Nico now has control, or is contested by number 12 on Diamond. Conley ball, folks. We have Sass inbounding it yet again. Passes off to Nico. Nico sends it down to Jacob Castro again. A very reliable player. He can fill in for any spot, really. If you don't see him playing goalie, he can be anywhere on the field. Quite incredible, if I do say so myself. Have a little bit of a head volley right there before Conley snatched it back. Ruben then takes control of the ball. He's running it up. Passes it off to Nico. Let's hope it doesn't go out. Oh. Out on Conley.
I'm going to get him later.
Carmelo is not inbounding the ball for Diamond. I believe we had a bit of a sub here. Little switch. Okay. Ruben's gonna take the ball. Sends it back down. Ooh. Passes it right into Diamond. It's okay though. Once again, I think we're seeing a very guerrilla warfare like style right here, where we keep on constantly, we go for an attack, pull back, throw it back to goalie if things get too crazy, and send it right back up there. Very hit-and-run tactic. We have Austin passing it to Nico. Nico's going to run it up, I believe, and crosses it to Austin. It is now in the box. Austin's going to take it. Oh, and goalie grabs the ball. Good save. Very heated battle right now for the possession of the ball. Very contested. As you can see, both teams are very skilled. Very equal right now. It's one hell of a game. Ruben gains possession. Passes it up to John. John's gonna run it into the box and goes for a shot. Out, corner kick for Bishop Conley.
Said that.
We were gonna have Ruben take the kick. Oh, they give it to the short. That was John. Diamond has taken control of the ball. They're passing it back. Rather than their usual aggressive play style. Nico takes the ball. Throws it to Austin. Intercepted by Colin Mello. Ooh, a little bit of a body there. No call by the ref, though. Castro takes the ball yet again. Grabs it up. Tells everyone to move forward. And off with the kick. Very strong punt. Sends it all the way down to their 18. And their goalie has it.
So, what's their goal? What's their goal? Yeah.
So I believe we fouled, and Diamond now has a free kick. They get it inside of the box. I believe Castro's going to run up for the ball, and he grabs it. Rolls it off to Nick. Nick launches it up into the middle. Austin takes the ball, passes it off to Ruben. Diamond takes the ball, and number 9 seems to be bodying Nick Sass right now, but no calls at all, even though his hands are clearly up. And JP gets us the ball. Well contested for the control. It's a good take by him. Nico catches the ball, sends it to Austin. Austin kicks it up. Diamond has controlled the ball yet again. And Sass clears it. Sam heads it back. Diamond gets possession again. Nope. It's contested between Ruben and
number 30.
Cody Arruda. See Diamond moving over to their naturally aggressive side now. They pass it to Nico. Nico takes it up. Nico runs it up the side. Gets past to Austin. Austin passes it to Nico. Nico brings it inside of the 18, and Diamond takes it back out before launching it back upside. Oh. JP intercepts the ball. Austin takes it. And Diamond tries to launch it again before taken up by Bishop Conley. Chico then tries to place it in the center. And Diamond makes an offside. Free kick's gonna be taken by Aiden. Grabs it up, launches it on the right side, right to Sam. Diamond lobs it up. So I have control, bring it up the right side of the field. Sends it into the box, and strange shot, taken by number 11, which will result in a goal kick by Jacob Castro. As you can see, that's Nate Chim right there throwing the ball to Jacob Castro. Castro kicks it up to Aiden. I believe they're going to work the right side of the field now, folks. Switch it up from the first part of the first half. And I'd be out on Diamond. Conley ball. Okay, Nico takes the ball, goes for a shot, and their goalie takes it.
I'm gonna need a hot cocoa or something. Oh man. Right?
Okay, we have Chico inbounding it. Throws it into Aiden. Aiden passes it back to Castro, and Castro back to Aiden. Silva's gonna run it up a little bit. So it moves back to Chico, and Chico tries to launch into Sam. John's taking up the ball, and out by Diamond. Bishop Conley ball, John is throwing it in. We have Nick taking it up. Nick passes it to Nico. And Nico to Ruben. Ruben kicks it off Diamond's number 10. And oh, there's a bit of a foul there by us. It's Diamond ball.
Why haven't they been called for anything? That's wrong, you know. So why haven't they been called for anything?
Diamond kicks it out, that's Bishop Conley ball. Chico passes it up. Goes into Diamond hands. Or feet, rather. They're inside the box. Oh, Nick tries to clear the ball. Oh, what happened? Handball by Diamond. That's Conley ball, boys. Got Nico taking the ball up yet again. Passes off to Ruben. And Ruben passes into John. Unfortunately, that's out though. Chico passes off to JP. JP passes off to Nico. Nico passes it to, I believe that's Brandon we see on the field now, folks. Ooh. Ruben takes a shank shot. This is going to result in goal kick for Diamond. Off. Very well placed boot, but Ruben takes control of the ball. Nico runs to recover, stops him from going out, kicks it into the box. Diamond tries to volley it out. Nico's still gonna press and into goalie. Goalie boots it up the field. Back to Archico. Kicks it up to John to Brandon, and it's out. One thing I'm surprised Diamond has not been doing is using their speed right now. There was a couple of moments where they could have drove it up the field and tried to make a shot, but haven't been doing so.
So is Diamond generally a faster team than Connolly?
I would say we're pretty even speed. I mean, they may have a couple of people that are faster than us, but they are generally known as a fast team. Maybe the fastest overall in the league, besides for us. They have been using their aggression sometimes, though. They've been very aggressive and offensive. Oh, and we have a shove by Brandon. Skinner is on a free kick. And, 17. Austin takes the ball, dribbles it through, down to Nico. Nico kicks it up to Brandon. Contest for the ball, but Diamond emerges victorious. Nico tries for a slide tackle and misses. And Diamond kicks the ball right to Ryan. Chico then kicks it out and is now Diamond ball. Possession time I've seen is being pretty evenly distributed. What do you think, Mr. Feeney?
Well, given that I'm not going to profess to be a soccer expert, but yeah, I would generally agree. I'm just interested in the what I'm watching as a novice soccer person is the point that you made earlier about there seemed to be a pattern about Connolly working the left side of the field, so I've been trying to pay attention to that. It's pretty interesting.
I've been working the left side a lot more.
Yeah, we have Nico taking it up yet again, dribbling it through the contestants. That's another thing I forgot to mention earlier. Nico also plays for a national team, went to Italy last year. One of the best dribblers on the team, however. And there's a trip. That's going to result in a free kick, and Ruben, one of our captains, is going to take that shot. And Ruben takes it. I believe there was a foul somewhere in there. I didn't get to catch it though. Oh, offsides. Okay. Nico passes it up to John John. John John kicks into Austin. That should be open ball for him. Oh! And there's a tangle there, folks. No foul, however, though. We have a lot of hands in that little competition right there. Ref seems to be getting a little aggravated. Diamond's gonna take this free kick. And Ruben recovers it. Some great boxing out by Nick Sass. Brandon's running up for the ball. He's gonna rev the kick. Nope. And it's back out. Chico's going to be inbounding. And he gives it to Brandon. Ball's being contested. Ruben down to Nico. You go to Brendan, or Brandon, Brandon Chico. And apparently another offsides. I don't know about that one, folks. It seemed kind of close to me, but. Diamond's taking the ball out. Contested ball, and Conley remains victorious. Okay, kick it up. Castro recovers the ball and kicks it to Ruben. Very even match right now, folks, but I believe that eventually one of the teams will let up right after halftime.
How many shots have you taken so far?
As you can see, Diamond's been being worked a lot defensively as we've been running it into their box a lot more than they have been doing to us. Diamond's maybe done it 3-4 times and we have around 7. Getting up there close to double digits. Just haven't been taking enough shots. And Diamond then inbounds it into the box. John tries to clear it and Diamond recovers. Diamond's running the ball back to their side before kicking it back up to us. And Aiden clears it. Brandon takes the ball, passes it to John. John to Nico. Passes it back to John. John fumbles it. I believe we got possession. And now it's Diamond. Inbound becomes cleared by Aiden. Pass it to JP. JP passed it to Nico, and Diamond clears the ball, or tries to at least before Ryan takes it back up. And that is halftime, folks.
Okay, folks, it is halftime. We will be back with you with some general commentary in a few minutes.
Thank you.
Okay, folks, we're just about ready here to resume action at Connolly Stadium. Pretty evenly contested match, as Nate did a great job of calling that, and we're moving into second half no score. It looked as if, I mean, Nate was the first one to point it out, so I don't want to take credit for the analysis, certainly, but it certainly did look like Connolly was making, at least during the first part of the game, try to chip away on the left side of the field. But a couple of things that I did want to mention. Connolly Open House is this Wednesday from 5 to 8. If anyone is, hopefully we have people who are interested in coming to Bishop Connolly. And I also wanted to mention about the Bishop Connolly cheerleaders. They will be performing at the Dunkin' Donut Center during the intermission, one of the two intermissions of a Providence Bruins game, I believe. Do you remember the date of that?
That would be November 19th.
November 19th. Okay, let's turn this back over to Nate Machado for play-by-play.
And we're back, folks, and Diamond has control of the ball. I'm going to bring it up there, right? Oh, yep, right here.
Finding out the name of the goalie. Oh, it's all right. No, it's...
Okay, they seem to have fouled us. Ruben's gonna take a free kick right now. Tries to pass it to Sam. Diamond intercepts, and it looks like we're gonna have a bit of a contest for the ball again. And Ruben chips it up to John John. John John takes a shot, shanks it. And here comes a goal kick, folks. And we're off. Boots it straight into John John. John John heads it. And now it'd be Curtis Mello kicking the ball straight into Aiden. Aiden's going to give it back to Jacob. I don't know if I said this before, but they play on a national team together, so they made a bit of a bond there. The team's chemistry is very impeccable. As I've seen for the last couple of years, they've all been playing with each other and really growing and knowing each other and becoming great friends, all of them. So, trust and all that is not something they have to worry about on the field. Have Nico bringing it up with his incredible dribbling. And he tries crossing it to Austin. Ooh! And a goalie takes it. Sam flicks it up. Diamond tries to take it. Sam contests the ball, passes it down to Nico. Nico chips it over to Ruben. And Ruben crosses all the way down. Down to John John. John John takes a shot. And goalie saves it. Two shots in the first 3 minutes, folks. Things are not looking good for Diamond. See if they can pick it up. And the goalie takes a punt. Kyle Oliveira takes the ball. Lobs it down. Chico recovers. Passes it to Ruben. Ruben to John John yet again. Is he going to go on another run? And that's out, folks. Diamond ball. Sam steals the ball, passes it to Ruben. Ruben throws it back to Sam. Sam loses the ball and it is now Diamond's. Diamond's going to bring it up the right side of the field. Nick takes it, passes it to Nico. Nico's dribbling it up. Diamond contests and add on Diamond. Connolly ball. Nico takes it again after Sass throws it in. Pass it off to Ruben. Ruben chips it off. Hits one of diamonds. And I believe that's diamond ball, apparently. Doesn't matter because Sam takes it. Oh, Dirty recovers the ball, however. And Sam's going to press on the defensive. I mean, on offensive. Chico and 24 are going to run that. As you can see, 24 had a massive burst of speed right there. As previously said, Diamond is a very fast team. One of the fastest in the league. Easy. Okay, Diamond brings it in the box. And out on Diamond. It's going to be a goal kick. Castro takes the kick, and it's now diamond ball. Off of number 10 on Diamond, Conley ball now. John passes it to Ruben. Ruben passes it up. Yeah. Diamond takes the ball. Aiden contests, throws it up sidelines, and it's out. Sam takes the ball. Diamond steals it. Ooh! And Aiden clears it. Very nice interception. Diamond crosses it into the box, but, I mean, the 18. Castro saves it, takes it up, punts it past the half, and Diamond takes the ball. They try to chip it up. Aiden playing some very good defense, backed with Kyle. Now stops the ball. It's passed to JP. JP passes it to Ruben. He's taking up the mid. Throws it to John. Now it'd be Curtis Mello giving John a little shove there. John passes up to Sam. Sam's going to pass it over. Oop. It's an 18, and the goalie takes it. Down to Castro kicks it up all the way down to Nico, but that's out. Diamond ball, folks.
Got the Eskimo suit.
Tries to clear it. Number 10 takes the ball. That'd be Kyle clearing it. Right into 30. 30 to Curtis. Curtis to Dylan Harrop. To Dylan Harrop. A foul.
Who was 30? 30 on their team. I have no idea. Yeah.
Ruben recovers the lost free kick. Pass it down to Nico. Nico takes a shot. Shanked. Oh, nope. It was a cross. My bad, folks. kind of hard to see at this angle. Chico takes the ball, throws it up into the goalie. Goalie catches it. Wise decision by the goalie. Chico passes it to John John to Ruben back to John John, and John John's gonna bring it up before Diamond kicks it out. Ruben's gonna inbound the ball now. Let's see who he throws it to. That'd be John John. John John passes it back to Ruben. Ruben is now in the corner, contested by Dylan Harrop. That's gonna be a corner kick for the Cougars though. Ruben throws it in with a rather low kick to the middle. Diamond's gonna look to take control of it. John John passes it back to Chico. I mean, that was JP, not John John. Sorry, folks. Chico throws it out. A very controversial call there, folks. Diamond ball, but many of the fans and spectators are starting to boo the ref. They bring it into the box before Aiden De Silva clears it. By number 19, saved by Castro. Very close. That's why he's one of the best in the nation, folks. Castro throws it to Aiden. Aiden kicks it up the middle before intercepted by Diamond. Dylan Chico run for that ball before Chico kicks it out, I believe. Yep, Diamond ball. Castro takes the ball, throws it to Nico. Nico is going to bring it up, and he's running. Contested ball. That's Conley's, I believe. They throw it in. Nico takes it again. Nico runs it up into the box for another run before Diamond clears it. In for a contested area, and very slide tackle there. It was a lot of bodies fell over. Goalie kicks it into the middle, and Diamond kicks it back out. Something to spice it up a little bit. I don't know. Something to spice it up.
I can't hear.
Keep on going. Just wait.
Hey,
a lot warmer.
All right. Ruben takes the ball, kicks it up. John takes it, brings it into the box. Diamond contests. John's getting in there. Some hands in there, folks, but hasn't been called. All right. It'd be Conley ball. John's going to toss it to Ruben, but Ruben has a couple of bodies on him. And kicks it to John. Ball intercepted. Diamond kicks it to Nick Sass. Oh! 17 trips. Okay, let's see this. Nico's going to attempt to... Oh! There was a shove there. It's going to result in another free kick. Very aggressive game today, folks. We've seen a lot of bodies being thrown on both sides. A lot of contact. Tough rivalry between both teams. Ruben's going to take the free kick. Shoots it. And the goalie takes it. Goalie kicks it up. And out. Another body thrown onto Nico. Looks a bit hurt there. That's some sort of knee injury there, folks. He's grabbing it. Ref's coming over to inspect, but he gets up. Looks like he'll be fine. A little bit of a limp there. Looks like he's gonna walk it off. Ruben's gonna take another free kick. Diamond intercepts, heads it out. Number 30 takes it. Sam and Ruben running for the ball. Nico passes it to Ruben. Ruben takes it up, and Diamond swipes the ball from him. Conley ball, folks. Oh, a foul there by Sam Hartstead. Man, my hands. Ooh. Kyle reaches over. I believe that's number 12's bag for the header. But they draw a foul. Aiden's going to take the free kick for us this time. Okay, folks, looks like Diamond kicks it out. Okay. Another foul, folks. Looks like Dan's gonna throw in a couple of subs. looks like that's Diamond's free kick. Entering zone of play. Levin kicks it into JP. JP tries to clear it. Diamond recovers the ball. Out on Diamond. That's a Cougar ball now. Nico brings it back a little bit before getting swiped. It's a very contested ball. Possession has been very key in this game, folks. It's been... No team has held it longer than the other, I believe. It's a very even game. I believe with Nate's injury, it's been a bit hard on the team. Lost a very valuable player. Diamond's going on an offensive now, and it is recovered by the Cougars yet again. Diamond takes back possession. Sass goes to play some defense with Sam. And it's now in the box. Aiden clears it out. Number 10 from Diamond brings it back in. Ooh, and a kick. Oh, it looks like Diamond has someone down. Ooh.
What number is that?
Number 17.
17, that is Alex Almeida.
Alex Almeida, a senior on the team, seems a bit injured. So, looks like something with his ankle, folks. It looks like he's going to try to walk it off a little bit. Oh, a little bit of a shove there by Chico. Chico and Harrop going at it again. Contest of speed as well as strength. Sass clears the ball. Austin's running the ball up. Passes it over to Ruben. Ruben to John. John in the box, but Diamond takes control of the ball. Ruben goes to beat Colin to the ball. Dylan Harrop takes control. Pass to Chico. Chico saves the ball from going out. Harrop goes for the ball again. And here goes another contest. Kyle swipes the ball. The 17 close behind. Alex. Seems to be a foul there, folks. And a missed header by Diamond. Gonna result in a goal kick. Castro kicks it up. And it's out. Up And across to John John. Into the box. Slight call and pass it to Curtis. Curtis takes it up. Curtis passes it to number 11. 11 to Harrop. Harrop back to Curtis. And JP intercepts. Passes it to John John. John John to Ruben. Ruben kicks it a little too far up. Colin now has control of the ball again. Chips it over to number 5. Takes a deadly shot to the face. Still standing apparently. Whew. Hard hit. Assassin 10 race to the ball, but Diamond takes it. 11 takes a shot. Castro saves. Castro to Sass. Sass is going to run it up the sidelines. Passes it up. Hits Sam. Sam tries to pass it to John John. Gets intercepted. Goes to JP. JP makes a kick. Three takes it. Three lobs it in the air. Okay. Seems like a foul there, folks. Kyle. All right. Castro takes the ball, kicks it to Sass. Sass takes it, kicks it back to Sam. Sam's gonna run up the side. Touches too far, and there's another foul. Not sure if it's offsides or what, folks. Ruben kicks it up. Goalie takes the ball. Goalie rolls it back out. Diamond scrambling to keep control. Oh, they kick it into the box. Wait for Chico to get up there. Good save by Chico. Chico proves his dominance and speed on the field. While JP lobs it up to Ruben. And Ruben back to JP. JP is contested by two of Diamond's. Diamond passes it up to Harrop. Harrop's going to take it up on Conley. Oh. And out on Conley, apparently. Diamond ball. We have Curtis about to throw it in. And here he goes. Aiden heads it to Ruben. Ruben kicks it up the field. We have Austin running the ball before Colin kicks it back out. Curtis with the ball again. Passes to number 4. Number 4 to 12. And we have Nico looking to intercept there, running it up. And he takes the ball. Bringing it into the box. Into the 18. My bad, folks. And there's a foul. Foul by Conley. Goalie's gonna take that ball. Sam goes to intercept. It's out on Conley. Diamond ball.
I'm just doing it. You know I'm only doing it for the exercise, right?
Ruben chips it up. Diamond goes for the interception. That'd be Curtis. Curtis heads it to 14, I believe. But Chico takes the ball, tries to pass it to Ruben. Ruben takes control. He's bringing it up. Cut off by Curtis. Before, body checking, number 30 actually. Surprised the ref did not call that. And out on Diamond. Conley ball.
Did you see that trick? I'm surprised I didn't call that. That was bad though. Like, he literally shoulder checked him. Hugging it up. Oh.
Alright. John takes the ball. Dribbles it. Passes it off to JP. JP takes it. Kicks. And it's out. Goal kick, folks.
I'm making it big.
Still waiting for the goal kick. And he kicks it. Ruben tries to stop the ball. Diamond kicks it down the field. Castro being very offensive and taking the ball, going all the way up to a quarter of the field. Kicks it up to Nico. And that will result in Conley's ball. Nick throws it into Nico's possession. And out again. Conley ball.
People listen to it on the radio?
Diamond takes the ball. 30, kicks it up to 15. Aiden intercepts. Pass it to JP. JP to Sam. Sam back to Kyle. And Kyle to Nick. Nick's being contested for the ball right now. Diamond takes control. Kyle takes it back and clears the ball. That'll be Diamond's possession right there.
Oh, my.
You go on conleycougarsports.com, click on Ustream.
Ustream?
Ustream.
Let's get it. All right. Diamond kicks it out. Conley possession. Nick takes the ball. Throws it in. Nico grabs it. Nico brings it up the mid. Passes it to Austin. Austin to JP. JP to John. And John is going to take this up. Bring it into the box. And many side tackles. That is out on Colin Mello. Conley ball. Good clear by Colin. Next to Nate Chim, John is one of the most offensive players on the team. It's mostly him and Ruben that will assist, and Nate will finish the job. However, in this game, we're seeing John take up a different role because of his friend's absence. Ruben crosses it in! And Colin Mello saves it with a header. Very impressive. Nico's dribbling it up before Diamond takes possession of the ball. He kick it back to Kyle. He's going to look to stop him. Throws it to Nick, but it's out. Throws it to 30, chips it, cross into JP's path. But we have Curtis taking the ball up now. JP looking to stop him. And Chico is the one who ultimately clears it. Out on Diamond, Chico takes up the ball, throws it. And Diamond takes possession. Curtis Mello taking it up again before Ruben takes it from him. Passes it up to Sam Hartstead. Hartstead to Sass. Sass kicks it up. It's going to result in a contest over the ball's possession, but Diamond is going to take it. Before Sass kicks it back up again. And out on Diamond. Conley ball. Awesome, works it down mid, tries to get it into the box, but Diamond's gonna take that. Curtis Mello takes the ball, kicks it up to Dylan Harrop. Dylan Harrop runs by John, runs by Ryan, kicks it up the side of the field, and it's out.
Oh yeah, no. Oh, two people watching. And then there's people on the radio.
Chico throws it to JP. Before number 30 takes it from him. Three people.
Once people learn that we have this, the numbers will grow.
Oh, a little bit of a team check there, folks. Ruben takes it, launches it up to John. John kicks it up. Ooh. Diamond's going to take ball. Oh, before Austin presses it, but it's out. Good run by Conley. It's going to be Curtis throwing it in. Curtis to Harrop. Harrop back to Curtis. Harrop finds himself in possession of the ball again. For kicking it down to our goalie Castro. Castro to Aiden. Aiden's gonna work it up the right side of the field, left side of the field. Before sending it to the middle to JP. JP sends it forward. Right into John. John's gonna run it up on the right here, folks. Switch it up. Pass it to Ruben passed it to Austin before being intercepted by Curtis. Ooh, and a foul. Conley foul there, folks. Diamond possession. And the goalie takes a free kick. Passes it to 14 in the middle of the field. He flicks it up, passes it to 10. Aiden goes for the interception, takes the ball, kicks it up. John to Ruben. Ruben all the way to Nico on the left side of the field. Nico's running. Nico kicks it. Oh! And a miss. Goalie comes with a very clutch save. It's going to be a corner kick for Conley, however. Let's see if we can exploit this. All right, Ruben takes it off with a short. Kicks it right in. Oh, that looked like it was right inside the line, folks. Definitely a goal, but the ref did not call it, unfortunately. Oh, looks like someone's injured or a cramp or something, folks. It's asking for the trainer.
Is it dead? Is it cracked? Oh! Oh my god, that phone! My phone dropped all the way from over here. Didn't crack.
No.
Swear! Oh my god! Yes!
No, lucky
bar. Barely right there. Oh my god. Oh my god.
I knew I'd call it up.
Sorry about that, folks.
I can't believe that just happened. I cannot believe that just happened. That has to be the most durable iPhone ever on dogs, bro.
Okay, so let's see who's taking it. That would be James Ribello. He's taking out some type of injury having to do with his lower left leg. Looks like a bit of a handball there, but no one called it. Austin loses the ball to Curtis Metal. Curtis bringing it up the midside of the field, midfield, before being stopped by Ruben. Ruben takes the ball, launches it to John. It's not offsides, but the goalie takes it.
Offsides is when you pass it and your guy, because there's like a line of defense, right? The last person on defense, if you pass it to the person behind him, then that's offsides. You can't be behind their defensive line until they kick the ball.
Alrighty. Chico takes that lob, kicks it to Curtis. Curtis passes it. Aiden takes recovery, throws it to Nico. Diamond chips it out. Nico passes it in to John. John to Nick Sass. Nick Sass throws it up to Nico. Nico to Sam. Sam passes it to Ruben. Very good passing here, folks. Ruben! Ah, oh, shanks a shot. It's going to result in a goal kick, folks.
I can't believe that happened. Yeah, I'd be gassed.
You got like a screen protector on that? Like,
nope. Absolutely nothing.
Diamond throws it up. Before control of the ball is being contested. Going to result in a little header battle for 18. Throws it up to Curtis. Chico's going to run for that ball. Throws it by Curtis. Tries to run it by Harrop. John takes the ball. Runs it by. And Colin kicks it out. Very good push there by John. Very nice defense by Dylan Harrop, bringing it all the way back from the 18-yard line on the other side of the field. We're going to have Chico throw it in to John. John passes it back to Chico. Oh, that's full time, folks.
Okay, folks, that's it. From here at Conley Stadium, we have a 0-0 draw. So Conley goes to 14-0-1 on the season. And time. 14-1-1.
And Diamond, have their record, goes to 8-4-4.
Okay, so for Craig Machado, Nathan Craig Machado, and Colby Nowicki behind the camera, I am Mr. Feeney, the athletic director. Thank you for watching. God bless and good night.